Miss Carter?
Do I know you?
Oh, we haven't had the pleasure, but we may yet. You're coming with me.
I'm going to regret this, aren't I?
Absolutely. But when you're not humiliating him, that fellow up there is my butler, Edwin Jarvis. He'll help you in any way he can. I owe you one, pal.
The next time you approach a woman in a dark alley, you might introduce yourself.
Well, I shall endeavor to remember that, provided my concussion isn't too severe. Should you need me, call any time before 9.
What happens at 9?
My wife and I go to bed. 7 o'clock, Sherry. 8 o'clock, Benny Goodman. 9 o'clock, bed.
You're new to espionage, aren't you?
Far from it. Last summer, I caught the cook pocketing the good spoons. What now, Miss Carter?
Now, I go to work. I imagine you're looking forward to some peace and quiet. At the very least, having both feet on the ground.
Yes, I've allowed several of my duties to fall by the wayside of late. My next project is quite engrossing. A complete and total overhaul of the kitchen spices.
Fascinating. Where is Howard? I haven't heard from him.
Presently attempting to negotiate the return of his property from the SSR.
Well, let's hope next time he builds a better vault.
Actually, he's decided to destroy everything.
Really? Well, that surprises me.
He continues to believe that no government, even our own, can be trusted with those particular inventions. Especially this.
Howard is giving me this.
He is under the impression that the sample of Captain America's blood was lost when he was under Dr. Fenhoff's control.
So you are giving me this?
I owe Howard Stark a great deal, but he does not own my integrity. I am quite certain there is only one person in the world who knows what to do with this. You, Miss Carter.
Mrs. Jarvis! Miss Carter is here.
Miss Carter!
I feel like I already know you.
She hugs. She does not hug.
It's a pleasure to finally meet.
Yes.
Well, I'll give you both some privacy.
Excuse me, Mr. Jarvis.
She's an embarrassing creature.
He's too easy.
Jarvis? Have we ever met that guy?
You meet a lot of people, sir.
Seems very familiar. Weird beard.
Good morning. It's 7 a.m. The weather in Malibu is 72 degrees with scattered clouds. The surf conditions are fair with waist to shoulder high lines. High tide will be 10:52 a.m. You are not authorized to access this area.
Jesus.
That's Jarvis. He runs the house.
Jarvis, you there?
At your service, sir.
Engage heads-up display.
Check.
Port all preferences from home interface.
Will do, sir.
All right, what do you say?
I have indeed been uploaded, sir. We're online and ready.
We start the virtual walk around.
Importing preferences and calibrating virtual environment.
Do a check on control surfaces.
As you wish. To power down and begin diagnostics.
Tell you what, do a weather and ATC check, start listening in on ground control.
Sir, there are still terabytes of calculations needed before an actual flight is advanced.
Jarvis, sometimes you gotta run before you can walk. Ready? In 3, 2, 1. Jarvis, could you kindly vacuform a digital wireframe? I need a manipulatable projection.
...1974, Stark Expo model scan complete, sir.
How many buildings are there?
Am I to include the Belgian waffle stands?
That was rhetorical, just show me. What does that look like to you, Jarvis? Not unlike an atom. In which case, the nucleus would be here. Highlight the unisphere. Lose the footpaths. Get rid of them.
What is it you're trying to achieve, sir?
I'm discovering, I'm rediscovering a new element, I believe.
The proposed element should serve as a viable replacement for palladium.
Thanks, Dan.
Unfortunately, it is impossible to synthesize.
Get ready for a major remodel, fellas. We're back in hardware mode.
Stark, you know that's a one-way trip.
Save the rest for the turn, Jay.
Sir, shall I try Miss Potts?
Might as well.
The streets of New York City have become a battleground. The army is here trying to contain the violence, but clearly it is outmatched and not
understandable. So, Miss Potts.
Where are we, upstate?
We are 5 miles outside of Rose Hill, Tennessee.
Why? Jarvis? Not my idea. What are we doing here? This is thousands of miles away. I gotta get Pepper.
I prepared a flight plan. This was the location.
Who asked you? Open the suit.
I think I may be malfunctioning, sir.
Open it, Jay. That's brisk. Maybe I'll just cozy back up for...
I actually think I need to sleep out, sir.
Jarvis, Jarvis? Don't leave me, buddy.
What's the rumpus?
Well, the scepter. You see, we were wondering how Strucker got so inventive. So I've been analyzing the gem inside. You may recognize.
Jarvis?
Doctor.
Started out, Jarvis was just a natural language UI. Now he runs the Iron Legion. He runs more of the business than anyone besides Pepper.
Uh-huh.
Top of the line.
Yes?
I suspect not for long.
Meet the competition.
You are in distress.
No. Yes?
If you will just allow me to contact Mr. Stark.
Why do you call him a sir?
I believe your intentions to be hostile.
Shh. I'm here to help.
Stop. Please help me. I can't.
I found him.
Hello, Dr. Banner.
Ultron didn't go after Jarvis because he was angry. He attacked him because he was scared of what he can do. So Jarvis went underground, right? Scattered, dumped his memory, but not his protocols. He didn't even know he was in there until I pieced him together.
So, you want me to help you put Jarvis into this thing?
No, of course not. I want to help you put Jarvis in this thing. This is the opportunity. We can create Ultron's perfect self without the homicidal glitches he thinks are his winning personality. We have to.
I believe it's worth a go.
Maybe I am a monster. I don't think I'd know if I were one. And not what you are. And not what you intended. So there may be no way to make you trust me. But we need to go.
Right.
Well done.
A pinch of paprika. A pinch.
Is that paprika?
I thought it might lift your spirits.
Spirits lifted.
In my defense, I haven't actually ever eaten anything before, so...
May I?
Please. Wanda.
Hmm.
No one dislikes you, Wanda.
Thanks.
Oh, you're welcome. No, it's a... involuntary response in their amygdala. They can't help but be afraid of you.
Are you?
My amygdala is synthetic, so.
I used to think of myself one way, but after this, I am something else. I'm still me, I think, but that's not what everyone else sees.
You know, I don't know what this is. Not really. I know it's not of this world. It powered Loki's staff, gave you your abilities, but Its true nature is a mystery, and yet it is part of me.
Are you afraid of it?
I wish to understand it. The more I do, the less it controls me. One day, who knows, I may even control it. Neither did I. Tell me what you feel.
I just feel you.
It's all right. You could never hurt me. I just feel you.
Why would you think that?
Because you are.
We are an unusual couple, you know.
Oh, I don't think that was ever in question.